Hello and welcome to 9design 3D. Today we will learn how to make a snowfall for our cozy and landscape scenes. Let's go to the tutorial. First, we will add a plane for our scene. As you remember, we made it before as a particle system. We will use this plane again. And you can scale it. And G to move your plane tab. Go to particle system, press plus icon. As you see, we will use this emitter. Now, when you press space as the timeline, as you see, it following it like that, but we don't use this. Under the emission, you can set your number. It's falling too hard and we will smooth it with different things. Under the lifetime, you can set your snowfall's lifetime and set your frame start -250 because we want to make our first keyframe for still snowing. As you see, our frame end is 200, but we have to increase it. For our frame end, we will make higher it. It will still snow when the timeline is going. If you want, you can match with your last keyframe and particle system frame end. If you set it, let's look at other settings. Under the velocity, we will change our normal to the zero. As you see, it can be stretched when the snow particles between. And you can set your randomize because we want to random snowfall in here. They can across each other and they will use a bit complicated. If you want to see this the complicated snowfall, as you see, look at the plane. If you hiding it, it will affect will be like that. You can decrease your randomize. Under the fill weight, you can decrease your gravity. And gravity will affect for our snowfall, but we have to set it clearly. As the randomized, you can set it how you falling you like. When you increase totally zero for your gravity, it will affect really slow and complicated. With the gravity settings, you can increase a bit. And I like this look, and I will use this. For the snowballs, we can add something as a collection. Before all of this, we will add an icosphere for our scene. You can scale it and in tap to edit mode, open your proportional edit with O is the shortcut key. With the middle mouse button, you can set it and give a little natural shape for this. And don't forget to check shade smooth. Shift T to duplicate it. And for the other snowball, you can set a different shape for this. With again, proportional edit, which shape you want, you can give it. If you want to make rain, you can make raindrop shape for this. I will add them in a collection. You can choose all of it, press M and add them snow collection in. As you see in here, we want to add some material. If you want, you can download some procedural material from Ambient CG or Polyheaven, how you want, but as a trick in here, Blender. Before all of this, we will add a plane or make an example for that. Go to Edit, Preferences, and Add-ons, type Snow. As you see, Blender has own real snow. Add-on in here, we will use some trick in here. Press N and go to Real Snow. When your plane selected, you can press add snow and it will give a snowy look like that. It will cover up for your object. In the Cycles render engine, it not looks good, but in Eevee and VPO shading, our snow material will look like that. As you see, when we add a snow for our scene, this material it came in here. Now you can delete it. From here, you can set your snow material for your icospheres. And it came in here like a bit shiny. From the cycles, set it Eevee. And you can see now. Choose all of your icospheres and last selection material lütfen, Ctrl L and link materials. And now our snowballs are ready. Let's fold it them. Again, choose your plane. And under the particle settings, And under the Render tab, don't forget to uncheck your Show Emitter. As a renderer, we will choose the R collection and Instance collection. Choose your Snow collection. And it came in here like that. They are too small. We will make a bit bigger. Under the Render, you can set their scale and Scale Randomize. With the scaling randomized, it will look more natural. There is no light in our world scene. If you want, you can set your world color how you want, but I want to add some sky texture in here because I want to see my snow how it looks clearly. You can add under the world sky texture. And you can set your sun elevation or rotation from here. For the see that clearly, you can add a plane for your scene, rotate, scale and place it. With your camera angle, you can set it. Add a black material for this. For now, if you work on in a landscape, it will look good. And extra, you can add some fog. Our snow particles will look like that. You can set your scale and scale randomness again. If you want to make some snowfall thunder, you can set something under the children. Choose your simple. As you see, they will look together. For your displays amount, you can set it how you want. And if you want for this type, add some wind force field. But I won't use for this. Now you can set it none again. With the Shift A, we will add some wind force field. There's a type in came in here. As you see, it affects now. When you rotate it, it affects for your snowfall where you put your wind force. As you see, when you put it for the right, and you can change your strength. If you give high strength, it will be look like a bit of snowfall thunder. This method is really lovely. You can use it. If you want, you can change your wind force field, place, and use it. But especially take care of it under the emitter, set it truly. Under the particle system, if you want, you can set your number up and give a snowfall thunder for your scene or landscape. Which shape you want, which type you want, you can use any scene of it. Thank you for watching. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later in new tutorials.